Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel, New Yorker Reacts. I'm a New Yorker and today I'll be reacting to Selena Gomez's brand new single, My Mind and Me, the official lyric video, because there is no music video, unfortunately. But I'm really excited because this is Selena Gomez's first brand new song in English, to be clear, in a while. Wait, could I be lying? No, it is, right? Maybe I'm lying. If I am lying, I apologize. I feel like it is the first English song in a while, though, from her. Regardless, I'm very excited about this. I believe she made this song to help promote her documentary on Apple TV Plus, you know, Apple's subscription service, which is also titled the same. The documentary has the same title. I'm very, interested in watching that. I've heard a lot of good things. Like, she's really open about her mental health struggles, etc. I also hear that she's like quote-unquote beefing with her best friend that donated her kidney to her, which is none of my business. Selena's like the sweetest person ever, so I find it hard to believe that Selena's like the bad guy here. Everyone seems to be painting her as like, oh, like she was drinking the minute she healed from like the kidney surgeries and whatnot. I don't know what the situation is entirely. I just know that they're two grown adults. They're really close with each other. Everyone fights with their closest friends. I'm hoping and I'm sure that they'll get back together if they are kind of like iffy. Also, I think it has to do with something that she said about Taylor Swift being her only friend in the Hollywood industry, right? It's very little things that I think are meaningless when it comes to a friendship where someone was willing to give you an organ. I feel like that tells me that their friendship is much stronger than these little issues that they have, so I'm not even worried about that. Anyways, let's get right into this lyric video. Let's not waste any more time. I know I like to ramble, so I'm sorry.
When I hear a part of my story, I try to hide in the glory and spit under the tables. My mind and me, we don't get along sometimes, and it gets hard to breathe. But I wouldn't change my life, and all of the crushing and burning and breaking, I know now.
I don't know why I expected this to be like not a fun song, but it's like I don't know why. Like, this is to help promote the documentary about mental health issues. So of course the song is going to speak on that. It's a very serious song and I like that. And it's relatable. That's the thing. I don't know why I expected we were going to go like with something more like festive. I don't know why my head went there. But I'm not disappointed at all. This is really good. I love when, especially Selena Gomez, when she opens up about these things. I really love that. Because not a lot of artists do that. Even though right now it would seem that it's like a popular thing now, like everyone wants to be more open about mental health and speak on issues that were recently seen as taboo, right? Taboo. Oh my God, I can't speak.
If somebody sees me like this, then they won't feel alone. My mind and me.
The lyric video is so beautiful.
It's hard to talk and feel hurt when you
like the animations. I want to say that one thing I love about how this song was created is that you can tell they try to strip down the melody when her verses come up so that we can really pay attention to what she's trying to say here. And I love that. I love that we have this focus on the lyrics. I love that they clearly designed a song so that we can focus on the verses, because she's really saying something very important here. I'm noticing she's also like saying a lot about I'm guessing through her perspective, how things feel, like her mental health struggles, how it feels, and also just talking about how opening up about it encourages others to do the same thing, which is so true. So I love the serious tone about the song. Oh, this song is so beautiful.
If somebody sees me like this, then they won't feel alone.
made on iPad. Selena Gomez and Apple. Entirely made on iPad Pro with apps from the App Store. That's her second collaboration with Apple, right? I believe Look At Her Now was like filmed with like the latest iPhone at that time to showcase the camera footage and whatnot, the new cameras. I think Lady Gaga did the same thing with Stupid Love, right? So that's why there's so many Apple commercials, because I was playing this video before I started recording this. I was trying to like get rid of the ads, right, to have it like set up, and an iPad commercial came up, and then her documentary on Apple TV Plus came up as well. So that was funny. I love that she's working with Apple though. That's cute. My god, that song is really beautiful, and I love the serious note. And like I said, the way they designed it to make sure that you focus on the lyrics and her verses, and then the, you know, they bring back the melody a little more, right? Layers of it return for the chorus so that it sticks in your head. Like, I love when a song is just designed so intentionally, so properly, if that makes sense. And like I said, it's a serious song. It's her perspective on mental health struggles, and also speaking on like just having the courage just to speak about it, like encourages others, you know, like inspires others to speak on it. It's so important that we do speak on it, because you shouldn't be alone struggling, you know. You should have a support system, families, friends. So I love that. I love that she's really become like an advocate for mental health issues. I love what Selena Gomez is doing right now. I love her new show, off topic kind of, right? Her show, Murders in the Building, right? I haven't seen the second season yet, but I'm about to. But anyways, that's off topic. I just love that show so much. I love the first season. I can't wait to see the second one. I'm just waiting for all episodes to be available so I can binge watch. Because does anyone else do that? Like, I just have to binge watch it. I don't watch a whole season all at once, but I like to watch a few episodes in one day. The lyric video was cute. And they animated it all on an iPad. That's cool. Also, watch her documentary. I'm about to. I haven't seen it yet, but everyone's telling me good things about it. Like, they really love it. Because, you know, at the end of the day, the song and I'm guessing the documentary are, like, super relatable. So many of us are going through mental health issues that many of us don't want to talk about, you know? And that's okay. The choice is always yours. But at least someone is speaking, like, very publicly about a private situation. That's super important. Mental health is super, super important. So many people are struggling, especially with the pandemic, the political polarization, etc. So many issues that are surrounding our country, our world, our society. So many things are going on right now. Anyways, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Make sure to subscribe if you like to see reaction videos, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Also, please let me know what you thought of the song down in the comments down below. Did I say down twice? Oh god, I can never speak on these videos. You guys already know what my issue is, like the nervousness on the camera. Anyways, thank you guys.